All right, so in this video, let's try to see how we can actually figure out last rows, last columns, maybe first row or first column in our data. So let's start by removing some of this. So far, I'm gonna start with this workbook variable we got here. So from this workbook, we're gonna do get worksheet, and we're gonna get this worksheet data tab, which is this tab right here. And at this point, the source sheet will be the variable that's gonna hold this worksheet for us. So if we go here in our next line and do source sheet dot and do get, we should be able to find this method called get used range. And as you can see, it has this Boolean optional in it. And I'll get to it in just a second. So for right now, we're gonna leave it empty like so. We want to store this in a variable for now. So let's just create a variable. I'm gonna call it used range. And for now, let's try to console log that used range and see what range that actually is. So I'm gonna do console.log. And here we'll do used range. Now that's gonna be an object. So to be able to see what that range is, let's try to do something like get, is it A1 or what is it called? Let's see. This should work. So let's try that. So hopefully that will be a readable range for us so we can see what it is. So I'm gonna go ahead and save this and run. And you can see we got this through this console log. So using this console log, we can print things in our console. If for whatever reason you don't have this showing up, you should be able to open that by clicking under this more options and then logs. And that should open this panel. So as you can see with console log, we can basically see that the range here is from A4 through G16. So A4 through G16. So what that means is that it was able to find us the range of cells that has been used in this particular worksheet. And you can see on the top here, the first cell we have here is this cell in this corner. And then the last column we got is this G column. And then finally, the last cell used in the spreadsheet is this color-coded cell. So therefore, this is the range it found. Now, even though there is nothing in this cell, it's just formatting, it still thought that this is used. This is where that other parameter comes in here. So I can pass true here. And what this means is basically only look at cells that have something in them, some value in them. We don't care about their formatting. So at this point, if I rerun this, let's save it first. See, we get a new range and you can see it goes from A4 through G11. So from here through here. And now using this now, we could figure out what's the first row, what's the last row, what's the last column or first column in this range. So the way we could do that, we could take that used range. And on this, we can do get last row. And this get last row is gonna take this used range. And out of that, it's gonna get this last row. Now, at this point, if we could just figure out which row number this is, we should be able to get the correct number. So the way we can do that, we can do get row index. And I'll just go ahead and save this in a variable. So let's try to console log this last row so you can see what's in it. So I'm gonna save this, run it, let's click away. So now if you look here, I got 10. So if you look here, it looks like the row is actually 11, right? But you wanna remember that these are indexes, and indexes for us start from zero. So the way this goes, it goes 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So with that same logic, now we could get different parts of this. So for example, if I wanted to get the last column, I would do some variable here. Let's just do short, last col. And here what we would do, instead of getting the last row in our data range, we'll get the last column. And then we can get our column index. And that should get us the last column. So let's go ahead and console log this now so you can see what that is. I'm going to save this and run. And as you can see, we get 6. And again, the column here is actually going to be 7 with 0 count, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That would be the last column here. Let's see if we can also get the first row. So again, we're going to get used range. And for this one, there is no way to get first row method here. But if we just do get row index directly on this, see, if you look here, what it says returns the row number of the first cell in a range. So that would be this top left cell. That should be the correct row for us. So if I go here and do const first row, and we simply just console log that so you can see what's in it, that should get us what we are after. 0, 1, 2, 3. That's where we are. And then finally, we can get the first column using the same sort of logic. So if I just repeat this, and simply just change this to get column index, similar to what's done here, only we'll do it on our used range, and it's going to take this first cell and get us what we actually want to get out of it. So if I do this save and run, that gives us 0 because our data starts in the first column. So now let's try to use one of those. So let's say what we want to do, let's actually simplify this. Let's delete some of these. So let's say we want to be able to run some script that will find the last row in our data, go to the next line here, and place something here in this next line. So for that, we can figure out the last row. So I'm not going to use all of this. We'll just use that last row part. And that last row is going to give me the index. If you remember, it's going to give me 3, so 0, 1, 2, 3. So just to refresh your memory, let me run this. See, 3. I want to now go here in this next line. What I can do here, I can take that source sheet and do get range by indexes. We have to give it a starting row number. If I wanted to start from here, that would be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, right? So here we get 3, but what we need is the one after 4. So what we could do, we can simply take that last row and add 1 to it to get to the next line, comma. And then I got starting column, so that's going to be always the first column. So we'll just do 1. Then we can do row count. So I'm just planning to add a single line to this. So I'll do 1 row, comma, and I'm going to be adding 3 columns. So I'll do 3. So this will be the range here. So we'll just save this in a variable. So we'll say next row range or something like that. And at this point, now within this, we can set some values. So we'll do set values. Since it's not just a single value, I want 3 columns of data. I will do set values. And here we're going to pass an array And it's only going to be a single row of data. So it will be one array in this array. And within that row, we're going to have three columns. So the first column, let's say I want this to say line 5. Then this should be, let's say, 22. And this should be 33. I'm going to save this. We'll go ahead and run this. And what should happen, it should hopefully find this next line and put that information there. So it says the number of rows or columns in the input array doesn't match the size or dimensions of the range. So basically, it's saying that whatever range was selected here doesn't match this. And I think I can see what I did here. I did 2 instead of typing 3 here. There should be 3 columns. Save this, rerun that. And now it does match. So I made a mistake here. This should be column 0, not column 1. So let's clear this. Let's try to rerun this one more time. So 0 index. We're going to run this. There it is. We went to the next line. We add this new line. Now, if I run it again, it should automatically now find the next line after this and place this information in our next line. And every time I run this, the line is going to be the next line after that, because we're dynamically figuring out the last row and then go one row down over here. And we basically add some information to this.